Hey everyone, Fallout here, and today we're going to talk about the Redrix Claymore and the soon-to-be new version of the weapon in Forsaken, the Redrix Broadsword. A lot of talking in this video, so feel free to look down below and skip ahead to the time mark that appeals most to your interests. Here's everything I want to cover. How do you get the Redrix Broadsword? How good is the Redrix Broadsword? And is it still worth grinding for a Claymore right now? Okay, how do you get the Redrix Broadsword? Starting September 4th, when Forsaken drops, you must complete the following pinnacle weapon questline offered by Shax. Step 1. In PvP, defeat 200 opponents with Pulse Rifle Final Blows. Step 2. Reach Valor Rank Heroic. Step 3. In PvP, earn 75 double plays. Step 4. In PvP, defeat 150 opponents with Precision Final Blows from any Pulse Rifle. Step 5. In PvP, defeat 50 opponents with Arc Final Blows, 50 with Solar Final Blows, and 50 with Void Final Blows. Step 6, complete 25 Crucible matches in Quick Play, then 25 matches in Competitive, then 25 matches in Rumble. Step 7, complete 20 Crucible bounties. And finally, Step 8, reset your Valor rank 5 times within a single season. And that's it. When you're done with all of that, Shax will give you your Redrix Broadsword. Let me back up. If you don't know, the Redrix Broadsword is basically an exact clone of the current Redrix Claymore, a 340 rounds per minute pulse rifle that comes with both Outlaw and Despacito, comes with both Outlaw and Desperado, two perks that go very well together. Desperado, when active, makes the weapon shoot way faster, kicking it up from 340 RPM all the way up to 600 RPM. So what is the difference between the two guns? Well, the broadsword is better. I wish I was joking. It's technically better because after you earn it, it'll begin to randomly drop from PvP engrams, and those drops will come with randomized barrels, magazine, and masterwork perks. So yeah, you're probably saying, wow, that is a long grind to get the broadsword. 8 steps, each one taking a pretty decent chunk of time. Yeah, you can totally do it though. Bungie designed this quest to be very doable by the average PvP player. The quest for getting the gun isn't so much hard as it is long, Kappa. The good news about earning the broadsword is that there's no real way to lose progress. Yeah, it might take you a while depending on how much you like playing PvP, but you're constantly moving forward with every bit of progress you make. There's no way to slip backwards. The Claymore, on the other hand, was a real biatch to get. If you were a PvP high roller, the grind didn't take nearly as long, but it was pretty friggin' intense. Because you had to reach a certain competitive rank to get the gun, it was very easy to lose progress even while trying your best, which really sucks. And it's definitely the reason that only about 9,000 or so Destiny players have wound up with the Claymore so far. Overall, very low number. So, why don't we answer a pretty important question? How good is the Redrix Broadsword going to be in Forsaken? Will it be worth the grind? The short answers are, it'll likely be outstanding and absolutely will be worth the grind. Here's why. Currently, the Claymore is hardly used at all in PvP, you've probably noticed, but that's mostly due to two things. One, not a lot of people have it, and two, the current time to kill in Season 3 makes the gun not terribly amazing. However, on August 28th, 1 week before Forsaken drops, Bungie is releasing a gigantic sandbox update in prep for Forsaken. This update, among many other things, will be the one that changes the current weapon system as we know and also updates the in-game time to kill. Basically, all the guns are changing drastically and we're going to be able to kill one another in PvP much quicker. While we don't currently know all the new damage numbers for every weapon and every weapon archetype, it's not really hard to take an educated guess or two as to what they might be, especially after what we've already been shown from Bungie. Warning! This video is about to briefly contain numbers. That's right, put the kids in bed and draw the shades, because we're about to get down and nerdy. If you're frightened by numbers, then please consult a physician, or just go ahead and skip ahead in the video and stop bothering other people in the comment section about how you're crazy and think that a little bit of math makes things not fun. Nah, dude, you make things not fun. Anyway, like I mentioned, the current time to kill for the Redrix Claymore isn't that that hot unless you have Desperado active, but again, that is about to change. With the current damage on the Claymore, two full bursts into somebody's head is not enough damage to kill another Guardian. You need at least 7 bullets, aka 2 full bursts, and then the first bullet of a third burst, and they will all be right in the dome, and that will be enough to kill. In Bungie's Forsaken PvP stream, we saw the damage of a 390 rate of fire pulse rifle, 31 crit damage, and 20 body damage. Now, there is no way on God's green earth that Bungie would ever make a slower shooting weapon do less damage than a faster shooting weapon, so we can only assume that in Forsaken, the Redrix Claymore and Broadsword, being a 340 rate of fire pulse rifle, will naturally hit a little bit harder than a 390. You see where I'm going with this? So just guessing what the damage numbers will be isn't that hard, and based on these guesses, it's very easy to assume that the Broadsword and the Claymore will be able to simply two burst enemy Guardians in the head. That's awesome news, because remember, the gun's unique perk, Desperado, once activated, it allows you to fire the gun at lightning speed, like I mentioned, 600 RPM. Time to kill-wise, two bursts with the gun in regular firing mode clocks in at around 0.88 seconds, but in fast fire mode, that drops to about 0.5. That is crazy fast. Ever get killed by a Dire Promise hand cannon in PvP and you thought to yourself, wow, that was pretty quick? Yeah, the optimal time to kill on that gun is 1.2, and the new broadsword can clock in at 0.5. Wrap your noodle around that one. Two more fun facts for you about the Redrix weapons. One, you can prolong Desperado while looking for new enemies by continuing to shoot and reload your weapon during Outlaw. As long as you're reloading during a period of Outlaw, you've got Desperado ready to go. Fun fact number two, Desperado lasts long enough for you to unload 2 full magazines of the Claymore while active. That is a lot of bullets. You have more time using Desperado than you think. The thing about the Redrix weapons that is really going to make them more valuable is the brand new PvP mode, Gambit, aka the fusion of both PvE and PvP together. It is going to be really easy to activate Desperado and Gambit since it's part PvE. You could, theoretically, quickly shoot a weak, trash level enemy like a Thrall or a Dreg, whatever, proc Desperado, and then go PvP mode and carve through the enemy team with lightning quick 2-burst kills. In short, if you're a pure PvP player, or if you really want to get into Gambit, getting the broadsword should be right up at the top of your to-do list. Which brings me to the next question to answer. Should I finish grinding for the Claymore right now? If you're close, yes, definitely. And I know, playing comp in the Season 3 meta, you'd probably have more fun slamming your head into a refrigerator door. Hey, look on the bright side. You have up until September 4th to get it done, and if you do it after August 28th, you get to do it in the faster time to kill PvP meta, which might be more fun. Very obvious question though, why on earth would I suffer through Season 3 comp to get the Claymore if I can just get the broadsword when Forsaken drops? Great question, Billy, not a bad idea, but again, it's gonna take you a while, and if you have the Claymore going into Forsaken, you get the broadsword 100% for free. No long PvP quest, no grinding, no nothing. Day one, you just walk right up to Shax and you say, "Give me that broadsword, bruh," and he just gives it to you, the way it should be. So, even though grinding for the Claymore definitely sucks, it has the distinct advantage of letting you not only use, but abuse the broadsword day one in PvP of Forsaken. If you really, really want to go into Gambit right away and just start crushing people with a gun that we already know is going to be crazy good, then get that Claymore now while you can, buddy. Then again, if you kind of think this type of gun won't really be your thing, no biggie, just get the broadsword whenever you have time to finish the quest naturally. With the numbers, it'll be a great gun for sure, but with Forsaken, there's also probably going to be a ton of awesome new viable weapons that'll put in work in Gambit, PvP, everywhere the Claymore shines. Hope I did a decent job answering some of your Claymore and broadsword questions. Do me a personal favor, if you haven't already, please click the subscribe button. It is free, and it helps my channel grow. Likewise with clicking that like button. Do both enough and eventually we will take over the world. You want to be a part of that, don't you? That's what I thought. Also be sure to follow me on the other places that I hang out occasionally, like Twitch and Twitter. Thank you again very much for watching. Hope you learned something. See you next time.